Welcome and thank you for joining us. My name is Andrew and this is Chris. Today we're excited to share with you one of the newest additions to the TruBend line at TRUMPF. This is the ToolMaster in its second generation. In our program today, we have a lot of exciting topics to cover, including some of the finer details of the ToolMaster, how easy it is to load a tool in, and of course showing you how to do a tool change and bending a couple parts as well. At the end, we'll have a live question and answer session, so if you have any questions, please feel free to enter those in and ask us at the end. There's a lot to get to, so let's get started. For those of you who might not be familiar with the ToolMaster, this is an automatic tool changer that can connect to your press brake. The main advantages here are that we're going to be able to automatically transfer tools from a tooling library, tool storage, onto the press brake with very little operator intervention. So this is going to, first of all, reduce the learning curve for new operators, make it easier for them, and of course, reduce fatigue as well. And overall, this is going to be streamline the setup for the operator and eliminates the need to search for tools and reduce that turnaround time in between jobs. When we look at the broader press brake portfolio, we have three main types of machines. The first one is our standalone machine, where you have an operator standing in front of the machine bending a part. We offer these types of machines in anywhere from 40 tons on the lower end all the way up to 1,000 tons. So we're definitely able to cover all of your needs on manual standalone bending. Looking at our automation side, this is where we take a press brake and have a robot in front of it. We offer a couple different size machines, the TruBend Cell 5000 and the TruBend Cell 7000, and now also the ToolMaster, which you'd be able to connect to the TruBend 5000 series, either in a standalone or in the cell environment. Finally, we have panel bending, and so we have a couple different offerings there as well. And so if you have any panels or forms, anything like that, profiles, not forms, we're able to fold that on our panel bending solutions. But today we'll be talking about the ToolMaster. Some of the highlights here, first of all, speed. We're able to go down to 10 seconds per tool. So that's extremely fast in terms of being able to do a changeover from one job to the next. Simple operation, we're using the same control that you would be comfortable with on your TruBend 5000 series machine, the touch point control, which is a TRUMPF designed HMI. And so, yeah, once again, if you're familiar with it, it's just one more tab on there, very, very easy to learn and use. Also standard tooling, so this is one of the big points here. We're able to use any wheel or new standard tool in here. There's no custom tooling that you need to buy. If you have TRUMPF tools already, you're gonna be able to put them in the ToolMaster. And even if you don't have TRUMPF tools, you'll be able to potentially connect them with an adapter into a wheel and your standard tank. Finally, a modular design. This means we can connect the ToolMaster to any TruBend 5000 series. This is all the way down at our 93-ton machine with the 5085 and all the way up to the 5320. So that's a 353-ton press brake. And we're going to be able to do the light gauge all the way up to the really heavy, thick stuff where, in my opinion, the payoff will be even greater with an automatic tool changer. To give you a little brief idea of what the agenda is going to look like, we're going to talk a little bit more about some of the features. Then I'm going to do a little tour, show you the finer points of the machine, some of the sensors, and then we'll load in a tool. And then finally, we'll also be doing a tool change in between two different parts to sort of show you what a production run would look like. And then finishing off with the question and answer session. If any of you are familiar with the previous generation ToolMaster, you can see it on the upper side of the screen there, and then the newer generation on the bottom. We've reduced the cycle time by roughly 50%, from 20 seconds to 10 seconds, and that's from an entire redesign of the system. The second storage capacity is increased by 50%, from 100 feet average to 160 feet on average, so even more tools, more uninterrupted runs. And finally, increased number of tools. So now we can put even more profiles in there and more types of tools, including custom tooling. Once again, you don't need custom tooling. You need just standard basic tooling. But you can put custom tools in there, as well as ACB wireless tooling and tools with adapters. looking at the speed. So like I said, up to 10 seconds per tool, 12 seconds average. You're going to be able to time that for yourself when we run the demo. QR code, so when I want to put a new tool in, all TRUMPF's tools now come with QR codes on the front. I just scan the tool, and the ToolMaster is going to be able to automatically log it and store it by automatically. There's no programming or anything else I need to do. I just scan the tool in, and the ToolMaster is going to be able to bring it in. Of course, if you don't have a QR code, you can still bring a tool in. And then, of course, also the new drive. So we have two completely new drive systems here, redesign on the back that's going to make those picking and placing of, you know, storing the tools in the library even faster. On the operation side of things, for all of our standalone machines, safety is standard, which means the Benguard laser block safety system is standard. Now what we have on the TruBend 5000 series is the Benguard automatic, and this is a CNC controlled Benguard. So it's going to automatically drive up and down based on the program. If my tools on my program, for example, are 220 millimeters tall, it's going to automatically drive to that and calibrate itself. If the next program, the tools are at 120 millimeters, it's going to adjust for that as well and calibrate. My operators are going to have to do nothing, and they're going to be safe, and we're not going to be impeding the speed of production either. The touch point control. So here, the control, all the sort of buttons and everything for the ToolMaster are built in this control. So there's no additional screen like with the previous generation. So it's even more streamlined and easy to use there. And something finally here that many customers have asked about is a parking position. And we have taken that feedback and implemented it here on the second generation. So if you have a bend aid, which is a CNC controlled sheet follower or just a normal material handling shelf, you're gonna be able to push those all the way off to the side, and it's gonna be stored under the ToolMaster. The machine is also very smart. So we have sensors in the ToolMaster to make sure that everything is stored correctly and there's no collisions. So the first one here, each tool segment length is going to be checked. You can see that in number one, when we're pulling a tool in or out, there's sensors on the picker units that are going to make sure that the right tool is going to the right location. The second point here, there are going to be sensors to check that there's no tool collisions. Those sensors are going to say if there's a tool there or not, and then relay that back to the machine. And the third part, so there's, like I said, there's no programming involved. I literally load the tool in, and it's going to be stored automatically. So the ToolMaster takes care of the optimization and storage, and I don't have to worry about any of that. So looking at this, we have the largest library on the market, and we're very proud to be able to say that. We're able to hold somewhere between 32 feet and 130 feet more tooling, obviously depending on what machine you're looking at and what options we have on here. And what comes standard are three rows of upper punches and three rows for the lower dies. And you can expand that to four rows total, so four rows of punches and four rows of dies. And that would mean an increase from 160 feet standard to 210 feet with the upgraded storage. And what we'll be looking at today has that upgraded storage, the four rows for each. So now we've come to the point, I'm just gonna give a quick tour of the machine. So you have a better idea of how everything's laid out and what it all looks like. So behind me is the TruBend 5170. This is a 187 ton press brake with a 10 foot bed. And we're going to be able to connect this to the ToolMaster. So when we're going to take a closer look just up here. So here I'm going to try to stay out of the screen as much as I can. The first part, we have the press brake on the left-hand side, and then the bridges. So there's two bridges, one for the punch, one for the die, that are going to rotate and connect the ToolMaster to the press brake to allow the tool transfer. There's also a physical barrier here when the ToolMaster is not running. And then the carousel unit. So the carousel unit is going to take tools from the back and bring them to the front for us and position them in the correct spot. We see the sensors here as well to determine if a tool is there or not as well. And then finally, we have the two magnetic slides. I know those might be hard to see, but we'll be seeing them quite a bit of them when we're doing the tool change. Those are going to magnetically connect to the side of the tool and drag them in and out. So that's what we have for the front side. We're going to take a look at the back now. All right, so here we have the back. I know the angle's a little interesting, so bear with me. Up here on the top, we have four rows of punches. And this can just hold so much tooling, I know that some of the rows are still empty. So, yeah, exactly. And then on the bottom side, so that's the punches. Here we have the dies. Once again, it can hold so many tools that in the demo showroom, we're not running production. We just don't have enough tools to fill the whole thing up. But you can see the four rows and plenty of storage space as well, just to give you an idea. For each row that there's a tool in, it can hold one type of tool and one segment length. So that could be a 210S, a 25 millimeters wide segment. And so that would be one row. And then if I had a 50 mil segment, that would go in the next row. You can also see here just briefly the carousel unit. There's one on the top and one on the bottom. And this is what's bringing the tool from the back to the front. You also can't see it right now. It's in sort of the side of the view, the two picker units. They're identical, mirrored, one on top of the other. But we'll be able to see those moving back and forth, bringing the tools in and out of the machine in just a moment. So that's what I have for you on the back here. Now we're going to head back to the front of the machine, and I'm going to show you how to load a tool in. All right, so right here, I'm just gonna grab my tool from the table. This is actually a 210S, the segment I just mentioned, 25 millimeters. And we can see right here, I'll try to get close to the camera, is the QR code. So all we have to do, Chris has set up the screen for us. We're just gonna walk over to the press brake, unclamp the tool clamping. This is a hydraulic tool clamping, and load the tool in. So I'm gonna fit it in right here, clamp the tool clamping again. And then of course I need a barcode reader. So I have my barcode reader, this is attached to the machine, and I'm just gonna scan it in. So now it's scanned in. I know it's gonna be hard to see, but right here we have the tool that's loaded on. If you're interested about the touch point control, learning a little bit more, or about the press brake, we do have separate presentations available on YouTube for you to watch. Getting back to the tools. So Chris loaded in a couple tools here ahead of time, just to save us a little bit of time. But right here, just to give you an idea of the breadth of tools that we can actually put in, we have a 35 millimeter wide radius punch. Next to it, we have a 12.5 millimeter radius punch, and that has two adapters on it. So you can see a 100 millimeter tall adapter and then a 50 millimeter tall adapter. And then the final punch here is a 200 millimeter tall adapter with an OW202K right on it as well. Looking at the dies, we have just a standard V die with a hemming block next to it, a roll bend 400, and then finally, a DV adapter or a double die holder with an EV001SW6 on there. So these are some of the tools. Obviously, there's more than just this, but this is to give you an idea. I tried to get creative in terms of what we're going to load in there to give you a wide variety of what we can offer. So I'm going to step outside of the safety zone here to make sure that I'm safe, and Chris is going to load the tool in. So all he has to do is press confirm, basically. Now that the light curtain's cleared, the control is outside of the screen, of that area as well. The ToolMaster is now figuring out where it's gonna store the tools. And all Chris has to do, he's slightly off screen, he's gonna press a green button there, which is the light curtain controls. And the press brake is gonna close those bridges that connect the ToolMaster and the press brake. And here are those magnetic sliding units. They're going to grab the tools, drop them off in the carousel, and then start putting them away. And you can feel free to time it yourself to see just exactly how quick these units are. So there we have the double die holder, one of the tall adapters. I'm going to throw them away. On the backside there, putting the tools away. So that's the last one. Drop it off. And it'll be on our way. So that's perfect. All right. So thank you, Chris. Right now we're going to switch back and have just another slide or two. And then we'll get to the demo and see a full tool change. So we just talked about some of the tooling. I mentioned that there's more. Here is sort of what you might be able to expect. This is once again, there's so many tools, I couldn't possibly put them all in one slide or one presentation. And I have some general rules of thumb on the next slide for you as such. But to take a closer look here, you know, you have your straight punches, you have your goosenecks, you have your offset or Z-bending tools, you have your hemming tools, you have your radius tools, and you know, those sort of sizes are also listed here. And then you have different adapters. So if I have TRUMPF tools, great, I can use height adapters. If I don't have TRUMPF tools, I have, you know, EHT, LVD, European style tools, right? I can put in here with one of those adapters and still use it in the ToolMaster. Looking on the die side of things, right? We're really not limited in terms of our angles or the type of dies. Once again, most of your tools that you already have, you're gonna be able to put in here, especially if they're TRUMPF tools or wheel and new standard tools. And also you can see the roll bend. ACB wireless is also able to be put on here, and we'll see that in one of the setups shortly, just exactly what that looks like and how it works. And further, also, if I have any custom tooling, I'm gonna be able to put that in here as well. If you are curious and you have some tools in your shop and you wanna see, will they fit? Well, these are the three specifications they have to fit in order to be used in the ToolMaster. The first one, it has to have a wheel and new standard tank. So I have a picture of it there. Once again, if you have a different style tool, you can always use an adapter to achieve the tank that you need. Second one are specific weight and segment length requirements. Some of the most important ones, I'm not gonna list them all, is the 55 pounds. It has to be 55 pounds or less. And then also, you know, for the punch, it has to be a 25 millimeter segment to a 500 millimeter segment. And it can be as tall as 340 millimeters and included the English or the Imperial units here as well, if anyone's curious. On the die side of things, we can go up to 120 millimeter wide die that is 150 millimeters tall. So quite a large die that we're able to store in here. And that goes back to, you know, that heavy gauge material that we can bend on these machines with the ToolMaster. The third is we need enough contact area for the picker unit, the magnetic shuttle, to be able to attach itself to the tool and slide it. So you can imagine the heavier the tool, the more friction force it has to overcome, and you need a slightly larger contact area for that. Most tools are going to be centered enough and have enough area there. It's just if you have some really offset tool, that might be someplace you run into an issue with. All right, and speaking of tooling, I know you said, I said you don't necessarily need to buy TRUMPF tools, but I am a huge proponent of them, and I just wanted to share that, you know, a couple quick facts on that. So our tools have a special laser hardening process, which is a combination of induction and laser hardening, which is going to increase a very high wear resistance on the working zones. And the working zones are the punch tip and the die shoulders. And that's going to give a hardness of 60 Rockwell C to a depth of 3 millimeters. And that's, of course, going to increase the lifetime of the tools, keep the precision and the accuracy of the tools, because this is what's touching the material, forming the material. And it's really important that they maintain their dimensional accuracies and tolerances to be able to do that. Further, you know, TRUMPF tooling is always innovating and advancing. One of the things that I like is the comfort slide. This is a rather new feature, and this is going to be standard on any tools that have a large offset or imbalance. So what I mean by that is a gooseneck tool. Most of the weight of it is on one side, especially for the larger ones. And when you're sliding in the tool clamping, it's oftentimes weighed on one side or the other. To facilitate the sliding back and forth for operators or for the ToolMaster, for example, the rollers are going to allow for less friction and less force needed to move the tool in and out. All right. And then also, so modular design, we can attach the ToolMaster to any TruBend 5000 series model, right? So you have the TruBend 5085, all the way up to the TruBend 5320, that 350 ton press brake. So I'm not limited on the flexibility. I can also retrofit it, so I could purchase just the press brake. A lot of our customers see huge gains in productivity just with that. And then they can decide later if they wanna add the ToolMaster as well. And this is also possible for the TruBend Cell 5000 to either add it or purchase it with the machine. So once again, light gauge and heavy gauge parts. There are a couple criteria. So this ToolMaster can only be attached to the new generation, the B23. That would be if your serial number starts with a B15. You need an opening height of 24 inches, the bend guard automatic, which is now standard on the machine in the US market at least, and hydraulic tool clamping, which almost every machine has. So, and of course, the one thing I failed to mention was the ToolMaster Prep. So this was available on machines starting May 2019 or later. So if you have these things, and once again, this presentation will be put online afterward, you can review it, see if your machine has that. Of course, if you have a specific question, I'll provide my email at the end, and you can send me an email to check for you if you're able to attach the ToolMaster to your machine. I've listed some of the technical specifications here just so that you can look at them later. But really, the one point that I'll take away from this is the accuracy of the tool positioning. It's 40 thousandths of an inch or 1 millimeter, so extremely, extremely accurate, more accurate than I could ever put the tool in the machine. So, you know, I rely on this every time I do a setup, and it works extremely well. I also oftentimes get questions about the size of the machine. So to give you an idea, we have the TruBend 5130X and the ToolMaster. It's 26 feet long, 13 feet deep, and 10 and a half feet tall. Of course, if you'd like a layout to see how it would look on your shop floor, please feel free to reach out at the end with the email, and I'd be happy to provide that. All right, so we've come to the point. We're gonna do a little machine demo, run a part, do a tool change, and run another part. So Chris, while I've been talking there, he's loaded some tools in, and he's bent a part fairly well along. There were quite a few bends in here, and so you know, the main highlight here is the tool change, not necessarily the part bending. So Chris here is using multi-stage bending, six-axis back gauge, and also the ACB laser. So the ACB laser stands for automatically controlled bending, and that laser system, you can see maybe the faint red line on the upper tool, is going to be giving him plus or minus 0.3 of a degree for every bend. So if that was a 90 degree, we could check on the control, and it would give a readout somewhere between 90.3 degrees and 89.7 degrees. Oftentimes it's much closer, but that's the rated tolerance. So there we go. Chris finished his last couple bends, and this is the finished part. So nice tight fit ups of the part, and it's looking good. That was the last part for him on his big production run for today. So now he's gonna go do a tool change for us, and we can see exactly what that looks like. One of the tools here in the setup is actually an ACB wireless tool. It might be hard to see, but I just wanted to mention that. And that's something that we can load in and out of press break with the ToolMaster without a problem. So what Chris is doing now is he's going to be bringing up the next part. He's gonna load the program, and then he's going to tell the ToolMaster to start. And that's basically it. That's how easy it is to do the tool change. There's no additional programming needed. Like I mentioned, it's just you load the program. Chris has cleared himself once again of the light curtain to be safe. Right now the press brake's loading the program for the ToolMaster. The ToolMaster's finding all those tools where they are, where they're stored, and then figuring out a plan which one needs to grab first. That would have to be the one that goes all the way on the left side of the press brake, and figuring out that order, doing all the computations to be able to load the tool successfully into the press brake. Once that happens, Chris is gonna be able to hit go and we'll be all set. The ToolMaster will start loading the tools out. And one of the things you can see here, so some of the tools we're using today are indexed in reverse. So when I load the tools in, I would put them in front, and the ToolMaster will be able to rotate them. So here we go. The first thing that will happen is the press brake will reference and open up to the entire opening height. This is 24 inches, so you can see how much daylight we have there to allow for also large boxes. Then the bridge closes, the door opens, and then the magnetic shuttles will come across to start unloading the tools. We have roughly 10 tools each for punches and dies. It might be plus one or two either way, but that's how many we're looking at. So if you are trying to get an idea or a feel of what it would look like in your shop or a cycle time, this is a real life example of what that might be. So one of the things that sometimes happens when you are running a press brake or doing a tool change, I'm guilty of this all the time, is the light curtain is broken. So Chris just stepped in front of the light curtain there, and the machine is going to stop. So what all he has to do, I just wanted to show you how easy it is to clear the error and keep going. Chris is going to go over to the side and hit play. The slide is going to be driven back into the home position. And then we'll be able to keep unloading those tools. And yeah, so I do this all the time. My hand crosses the light barrier explaining something, or I'm just careless and sort of walk in front, and the machine needs to make sure that we're all being safe. So, and there we go. The ToolMaster is going to re-reference itself. It's going slowly to make sure that there's no collision and no one gets injured. So that's very important. Once it gets back to the reference position, the bridges will close. The the press beam will come down a little bit. There we go, bridge is open. Press brake is gonna re-reference, bridge is closed, and it'll be back at it in less than 30 seconds. And you can see there on the top, we're gonna have that slow approach because we just wanna make sure that nothing happened when the light barrier was broken. So that's just another safety in there that's built into the machine automatically. And we're on our way to unload all these tools. You can also see in the shot here, the parking station. So that CNC bending aid and that material support are completely out of the way, right under the ToolMaster. So the operator can bend the part. You know, if he has a long part, 10-foot part, and has a down bend that would otherwise interfere with the bending aid, that's not a problem. And you're also not taking up any other floor space. You know, you do have the option for the park position left on the TruBend 5000 series, but you wouldn't need that with the park position built into the ToolMaster here. So there we go, we've finished unloading all the tools. A nice, clean 10 feet of clamping that we have here. And so what that means is we can start loading all the other tools back in. So this is the second program. There are quite a few tools here. We wanted to show you the full capability. So we'll be loading quite a bit of the clamping and both the upper and the lower punches and dies. So while I did say this is the TruBend 5170, 187-ton press brake, 10 feet, we offered 5 different models in the TruBend 5000 series line, starting with the TruBend 5085, which is offered in 6 or 8 feet formats. And this would be a 92-ton press brake. We also have 4-meter press brakes or 13.5-foot press brakes, and that's going to be able to go up to the 350 tons as well. So quite a bit of range and breadth in the line that we can connect to the ToolMaster to do those tool changes. You might also be wondering, how does the ToolMaster get such high accuracy? How does it get that 1 millimeter, 40,000ths of an inch accuracy when it's putting the tools in? Well, there is a laser system that you can see the little white tab sticking out of the box, off the top or the bottom of the box when the slide comes out. There's a laser that's reading the position based on that. So it's gonna be relaying the position of the slide back to the ToolMaster, and it's gonna give us that high positioning accuracy. One of the other things here is, with that high accuracy, especially for a setup in a part like this, it's extremely important that all the tools are in exactly the right spot. Even if they're off by just a little bit, we're going to not be able to hold the tolerances when you think about flanges and bending across different stations. So we have quite a few bends where we're using multiple stations at the same time, and the distance between them is critical to make sure that the part comes out correctly the first time. Right, we don't want to have to go through a couple blanks and then maybe get a good part. You'll be able to know your tools in the right location and get a good part on the first try. Another thing to mention, so this is always amazing to me, but you know, the time the ToolMaster sets the tooling up, if I was an operator, I would probably, you know, maybe just be finishing up finding the tools in my stack of tooling. So, you know, just when you think about it like that, and also, you know, the ToolMaster is going to give you the same time all day, every day. That's one of the benefits of automation. You know, maybe my operator does a tool change faster in the morning, but it takes them a little bit more time in the afternoon. ToolMaster, you can count on to plan your production quite exactly. So there we go. We have quite a different, or quite a few setups, six different setups. You can see right there, the bend guard's gonna drop down, gonna automatically calibrate itself. We have the ACV laser, which is gonna go into its home position. So it's gonna re-reference itself, and we're good to go. So you can see how little work that was for Chris. You just turn the screen and he's ready to go. So here we have a rather thick part. So this is a heavier gauge, 3/8 material. And you can also see the 6-axis back gauge in this shot. So that's what Chris is gonna be gauging on. That's going to give us a whole lot of flexibility. These are two completely independent towers. And Chris is gonna be moving back and forth. On the front side, we can see the tool indicator lights. These are LED lights right above the tool clamping, and it's going to shift from station to station. So Chris is all the way on the left side of the press brake, and those lights are as such highlighted. You can also see all these tools are indexed facing the back of the press brake. When we loaded them in, they were facing towards us, right, facing the front of the press brake. And so this just goes to show again that the ToolMaster is going to be able to index the tools front or back based on the part program. There's nothing else I need to do. Also, generally for a part like this, if I was doing a lot of types of parts like this or had normally 10-foot parts, I would probably have 2 foot pedals. What Chris is working with here is he's gonna be dancing around the floor in front of there with that foot pedal to be doing some of these bends. So this part I think has something like 12 bends or something like that. So it is quite a complex part. We were able to program this very quickly in our offline programming software in Boost, and then spit out a program to the machine either over the network or by USB. And of course, that the ToolMaster is just reading that program that we make in the offline software. So we can easily use that. There's nothing else I have to do. The tools are gonna be set up just like we saw. And we're bending away. So very easy for the operator to do. Seamless transition from the office out to the shop floor. And I think Chris has one more bend here and then we'll be all done with this part. And you can see right here, it's a great shot of the 6-axis back gauge catching that corner to lock it in, make sure the part doesn't move anywhere while we're bending. So there we have it. There's our final part. Great job, Chris. You can see those tight fit ups. The sheet metal looks very good. We're gonna be able to send that to welding if we need to, or paint, and we'll be good to go. So thanks to Chris, our great operator, and also our ToolMaster for helping out. That is our show for today. We want to thank you all for joining, for taking the time, and we'll go into our live question and answer session. Of course, if you have any other questions, I'm going to put my email on the screen right now. So you can feel free to either call or reach out through the email. We'd be happy to also see you at one of our TRUMPF locations worldwide. So yeah, thank you all and have a great rest of your day.